I am the director of the Center for Accessible Education. I oversee disability services at UCLA. I would describe it as a wonderful institution. We like to consider ourselves innovators in higher education. Our mission is broad in that, in addition to facilitating academic accommodations for students with disabilities, we really like to consider ourselves an educational resource for the campus at large. Total undergraduates and graduates, about 44,000 students. We have about 3,500 students registered with the Center for Accessible Education. We do know there are more students than that with disabilities on our campus. Most students, unfortunately, with disabilities do not register with disability services. I would say about a third of the students that are registered with us have a note-taking accommodation. That accommodation could be assigned to a student for a number of reasons. If you look at the history of note-taking as an accommodation, what was traditionally used was peer note-taking. And so what peer note-taking entails is the university identifying a student in the class who'd be willing to share the notes that they're taking with a classmate. As you can imagine, there are a host of issues with peer note-taking. Peer note-taking can be quite expensive. You could spend hundreds of thousands of dollars annually on note-taking, and then also you're spending money on a resource that might not be utilized. If you audit your peer note-taking program, as I'm sure most universities have done, you would find that students that are approved for it aren't downloading and utilizing the notes. When I first started at UCLA a few years ago, the other alternative to peer note-taking was a smart pen. Another solution considered is talking to faculty members and TAs to see if they'd be willing to share their outlines. But at the end of the day, that's all they are outlines. And so one of the reasons why we looked at technology-assisted note-taking is because we knew we had to find another solution for students. The game changer for us with Otter is the real-time transcription. And when you talk to students about note-taking, that is the piece that I think has been missing. And so we decided to launch a pilot last fall because I knew there were students on campus who could benefit from Otter. What I started to do actually was just use it myself. So I downloaded the app onto my phone, and then I would use it in staff meetings and things like that and just go back and review the notes. And I was just amazed at how accurate the transcriptions were. We want to innovate. We want to be the leaders on exposing our students to things that I think empower them. I think the wonderful thing about it are the 600 minutes per month for free. So you're able to try the app, see how it works without having to fully commit to it. Do your research and see what's out there. In 2019, we should be offering multiple options to our students. And Otter obviously is one such technology that we use. The uses of it can extend beyond students with disabilities. I just think there are a lot of opportunities just to enhance the student experience with it. So I'm pleased with it.